Hi, everybody. Welcome back to my kitchen. I'm Tina Wells from livingdeliciousnutrition.com. And today I'm going to be sharing with you some of my new favorite recipes, some things that I took a little time off to develop for you, and lots of fun because some of these are based on old family recipes and some of them are new just because they're some of my favorite combinations. And I really enjoy making healthy dishes, of course, from all of these pretty basic ingredients. But today I wanted to talk to you first about this main ingredient, which is blood oranges. Blood oranges are very popular in Europe and also here in the US, especially in the South. Look at this color. It's absolutely gorgeous. They're so fragrant, they're sweet, they're juicy, but the zest is really fragrant and very flavorful. So we're gonna be using the juice and the zest in this recipe today. And along with this, we're going to have some cucumbers and some fresh oregano. And I'm going to put this chicken over a very fragrant cauliflower rice. So let's get started. First, I'm going to make the marinade. All of these new recipes are in my new download called the Koutala Volume 1. And it's all chicken recipes, just really delicious recipes that you can do with a really basic ingredient, boneless, skinless chicken breast. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I have 2 teaspoons of turmeric. Just gonna put that into this bowl. And although I'm calling this a marinade, it really has sort of a denser consistency because of the ratio of onion to liquid. And you'll see why. I'm gonna cook all of these together and I don't wanna have to drain off the liquid. Next, I have some onion and 3 cloves of garlic. It's a 1 medium onion or half of a large onion. And the garlic is already minced. Took care of that so you didn't have to watch me make all of that. And I'm just gonna stir those together. I want everything to get that beautiful bright yellow color from the turmeric. And next I'm gonna zest this blood orange. Just go all the way around, and I'm using a planer. This is an actual tool for zesting, although I have to say in the old days when I was just buying equipment as cheap as I could get it, I would go to the hardware store and buy a door planer. It does the same thing, and it's a lot less expensive than what you would pick up in a gourmet market. I had more fun in the hardware store than I did at the gourmet or kitchen supply. So I'm just going all the way around, and you can see I'm just taking off the colorful part, but not the white. The white is what makes it a little bitter, and we don't want that. And that looks really good. You can see it's about a tablespoon. It all kind of landed on the spatula there. And there's a bunch in the back of this, so don't forget to dig that out. I'm just gonna use my finger and swipe it out of there. And it just smells so good. There's something about blood oranges. It's just a richer, sweeter flavor that I really like. And hello to everyone joining me. Thanks for getting on, and hopefully this inspires you to try a little cooking in your own home. Last, I'm just going to add 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Oh, hang on. Forgot to juice the orange. I'll do that because I want you to see the consistency of this. Now, if you have one of these squeezers, mine's a lemon squeezer. They make these in different sizes for a reason. I don't know if I'm going to get this orange in here or not. Sometimes I can just kind of pop it in there. I'm just going to squeeze the juice out of here. It's going to be about 2 tablespoons, you can see. And try not to splash it all over yourself because it does stain. It's that gorgeous ruby color. And you can see how this is coming together now. Very little liquid, but your chicken's gonna sit in this for about 20 minutes minimum. You can do it longer. The more you leave it in, the more flavorful it becomes. And here I have a few already sliced up boneless, skinless chicken breasts, and each piece is about an inch. Also be sure to pat it dry with some paper towels, because the more moisture you have in the chicken, the more it's going to be creating liquid in the marinade. And then when you go to cook it, it's gonna boil or steam rather than saute. And we want those nice brown edges on all these pieces of chicken. So this is gonna go away. I'm gonna put this aside because I already have one done for you. I'm gonna turn on my burner here. But before we do that, I want to show you how to make the cauliflower chicken, because that's going to need a few minutes on the stove to simmer. And while that's simmering, we can go back to the chicken. So I just have this on about medium-high heat. I'm going to add about a tablespoon of olive oil. And to this, I'm going to put some seasoning, and this is what makes it so, so fragrant. It's a half teaspoon of cinnamon, a half teaspoon of coriander, and a half teaspoon of ground cumin. You want to put that in the oil and let it warm and start to get really fragrant. And it's just going to make your kitchen smell so good. So you can see that's already starting to sizzle. Yeah, supuestas. My friend Chef Kostas Magoulas is with me here from Athens. Are you in Athens today? This is going to be a boneless, skinless chicken that I'm seasoning with blood orange, onion, turmeric, and then I'm making a seasoned cauliflower rice with the cinnamon, coriander, and cumin. And the other thing I wanted to show you is I grow my cilantro in my yard. So when cilantro goes to seed, it becomes coriander. So I've just taken those seeds and crushed them up here in my mortar and pestle. Use what you have. I mean, if you can get this and you don't have to buy it, you know, I'm kind of cheap, so. And now I'm just gonna add, because this is getting really fragrant, a tablespoon of garlic. And it's already minced, and you don't want this to go too far because you don't really want it to brown. And because the cauliflower rice is so wet, I'm just throwing it in frozen. So I have one bag of cauliflower rice. I might not add the whole thing because this is a really big bag. So I'm going to let this start to thaw and break down a little bit. And sometimes, you know, when you buy cauliflower rice, you can do this with fresh too, but I just like the convenience of the frozen, and I'm trying to show you some really easy methods to get dinner on the table. So I'm going to stir in all of that seasoning, and it's going to start making the cauliflower rice a toasty color. You know, I don't eat grain for my health, but if you tolerate rice or non-gluten grains, go ahead and make this with rice. You would add pretty much the same amount of ingredients. You might want a little more liquid. This is going to be a half a cup of bone broth that I'll add in a moment. But make the rice with the seasoning the way I'm making the cauliflower rice. It's just as delicious. I tend to stick to primarily plant-based dishes with a little protein on the side. So once the vegetables have that nice toasty color from the seasoning, just gonna go ahead and add about half a cup of chicken bone broth. I'm gonna move this over to the stove and let it simmer on the stove, and then I can show you the chicken right here. This will just come up to a boil, and then it'll go down to a simmer. And when it's absorbed all the liquid, don't forget there's some liquid in here from the frozen cauliflower rice as well. And when it comes back down to a simmer and absorbs all the liquid, similar to a rice dish, an actual rice dish, then this will be nice and fluffy and ready to serve. So let me put this on the other stove. I'll be right back and we'll go do the chicken. So as I said, the chicken had been marinating for about 20 minutes minimum, definitely more if you have the time. But this is one of those things that if you get home from work and you want to throw together a quick dinner, by all means, do it. So what I've done first is I've added about a tablespoon of olive oil, and I'm going to toast some pistachios. So it's about a half a cup of pistachios going in, and I'm just going to shake the pan so that it absorbs the oil a little bit. Now, the thing with induction is sometimes you can't shake because it wants to turn off. And this is the chicken that I've had marinating for a little while now. And you can see it's not liquidy at all. It has that nice seasoning and bright yellow color from the turmeric. And these are starting to smell nice and toasty. As soon as they start smelling a little fragrant, you don't want them to go too far. Just gonna put them back in this little dish that I had them in and let them cool. Raw pistachios are best. Try not to buy pistachios that are cooked in any kind of seed oil. I prefer to stay away from seed oils because they are inflammatory. They do have some chemicals in them that aren't necessarily good for your digestive tract or for inflammation. So I stay away from canola oil, sunflower oil, some of those kinds of things that are processed. But olive oil is always your best bet. A good Greek olive oil is even better. I do like coconut oil and avocado oil as well. So those are about ready. They're smelling really good. And the oil is shimmery. So I'm just gonna put these into this cup and we'll go back to these when the chicken's almost done. Now, in the same pan, just gonna turn the heat up. And when that oil gets really shimmery, we're gonna go in with the chicken. And while that's warming, I'm just gonna step off and check this cauliflower rice because I hear it sizzling. The other thing I really like to do is season as I go. So rather than putting the salt in when I set up the marinade so that it doesn't dry out the chicken too much, I'm gonna season it right now before it goes into the pan. And some pepper. I'll bring this back in the front so you can see. This is nice and hot. You want that chicken to sizzle the minute it hits the pan. Is it gonna do that? Yes. And make sure that it's spread out so that you're getting as much surface area as possible in contact with the pan. You don't want it to be all piled up in one middle part of the pan. And I'm putting all the onions and everything in. It's all gonna cook at the same time. And since these pieces are small, they're gonna cook pretty quickly. And I don't like to move it around too much. I'm just trying to get everything nice and flat, touching the pan so that it gets nice and brown quickly. So this is fun. The koutala is the wooden spoon, as I said at the beginning. The wooden spoon in Greek is one of those things that you either love or you fear, because if your grandmother or your yaya had the wooden spoon, she was either making you something really delicious or she was going to hit you because you've been naughty. We don't really use it for the latter reason these days, but I love the koutala. It reminds me of my grandmother. It's one of my favorite cooking utensils. And so I named this new cooking series the Koutala. Volume 1 is all chicken recipes. Simple, boneless, skinless chicken breast recipes that you can make that have delicious Greek flavors, are grain-free and dairy-free, but still so flavorful and so delicious. And I hope you enjoy them as much as I've enjoyed developing these new recipes for you. I'll be doing all 5 recipes, one each week, every Tuesday at 1 o'clock Eastern time here on Instagram on IGTV. Now this chicken is really starting to smell delicious, and you can see it's getting that nice brown color. So I'm just going to keep turning all these pieces and moving the ones that are on the edges to the center. I just like to keep rotating things around so they'll cook evenly. When you're cutting chicken breast, you have that little pointy end, and you want to make sure that those pieces are just as big as the pieces from the center, because you don't want those to cook off quicker and dry out and not be as moist and flavorful as the bigger, heavier pieces. And this is gonna just, if you have a nonstick pan, that's fine. This might stick just a little bit, but we're gonna deglaze it with a little chicken stock too. My camera, unfortunately, was giving me technical difficulties today. I do have my tracker on, but it doesn't want to follow me, so I apologize whenever I have the camera. I was hoping it would be able to track me around the kitchen, but it has a mind of its own today. So I'm going to go stir that cauliflower rice one more time, and then I'll be right back. It's almost done. I'm going to grab a little more chicken stock. You can use any brand of bone broth that you like, whatever you find. I prefer anything organic. This one just happens to be from Costco. I do like Kettle and Fire the best. I just don't have any of that with me here today. But feel free to use any brand of bone broth that you like. I do look for ingredients to be as minimal as possible. And since this is making some nice brown with the onion and herbs at the bottom, I'm just gonna deglaze the pan. Deglazing is when you add a little bit of liquid to the hot pan while it's still on a relatively high temperature, and it will lift all of these sorts of nubbies on the bottom right off from the steam that you create and add to the sauce. Just gonna do that and start stirring it around, scraping up all those little brown bits. That's just classic culinary technique. And this chicken is looking just about ready. So I'm gonna turn it off. I've done this entire recipe in real time with the exception of a little bit of prep, and it's almost ready to serve. I have some fresh herbs here, some fresh oregano, and some fresh parsley that I just have from my yard because I have some containers growing in the yard, and I have a nice large cucumber. I'm going to cut the cucumber on the bias, and what that means is on an angle. So when you serve this, you have as much surface area as possible, and you get even more flavor. So I'm just slicing about a little thicker than a quarter inch thick slices. That should be good. And then I'm just gonna strip the oregano. You know, fresh is always gonna be more flavorful than the dry, so you don't need to use quite as much. And the little tiny stems, I don't worry about. I just chop those right up. And I love being able to just walk out to my yard. If you have a patio or a balcony and you can throw some herbs in, I highly recommend doing that because they literally grow like weeds. We'll set that aside. And then we've got our parsley. I'm just gonna bunch it up and go through it. As always, when I am chopping anything, I'm keeping my finger forward, my knuckles forward, my fingertips back. Just gonna run my knife through this a couple more times to make the pieces a little smaller. Oh, the herbs just smell so delicious. Mix that over here with the oregano. And finally, just gonna take these pistachios we toasted, put them on the cutting board, and run the knife through these. You don't have to chop them up. I just like the mouthfeel. When you're taking a bite, you get a little bit of everything. And just enough to kind of break them down. You don't have to put them in the food processor or anything like that. And that's pistachios. And I'm gonna grab a platter and show you how to finish this whole thing and plate it up. So I have this nice baking dish. Our cauliflower rice. You can see how nice and fluffy it is. And one final touch to the cauliflower rice to make it really Greek. Of course, I don't eat dairy, but I love my almond milk dairy-free yogurt. And this is a brand that it makes a Greek-style almond milk yogurt. It's called Kite Hill. So I'm just gonna put about half of this container. If you do the full recipe, use the full container. I'm just gonna stir this in. My mother used to make rice, pilafi, as we call it in Greek. And she would always stir some yogurt into the end. It gives it a beautiful, creamy finish. You can see that's all incorporated into there nicely. And it also gives it that nice kind of tangy flavor from the yogurt. And now I'm just going to arrange the cucumber slices around the edges. However you like is fine. And now I'll place the chicken into the center. And you can put this whole platter in the center of your table. And the wonderful thing about this recipe is all the chicken cooked with the onions and everything at the same time. You got this nice little bit of sauce you can put on top. With these wonderful onions that got nice and translucent and soft. And now I'm just gonna top this with these fresh herbs. So you have that nice bite of oregano and fresh parsley and some crunch with these pistachios. Very Mediterranean, very healthy, totally dairy-free and grain-free. You can pick up all of my recipes in this new edition called the Koutala. If you go on my website and register for my newsletter, it's a free download. The website again is livingdelicionnutrish.com. Feel free to join me. I'll tag this recipe in my posts in a little bit. And let me know if you try it. Tag me on Instagram if you give this recipe a go. And I hope that I've inspired you to try some healthy cooking. Okay? Thanks again for joining me. Bye for now. See you next week.